Okay, hi guys. Just let me know if you can see me, hear me clearly. Good evening, everyone. Hello, everyone. Hi, Sohas. Hi, Manish. Welcome all of you to this session on horticulture. So Hansa ma'am is not here, and that's why I am taking some lessons on agriculture this time. When she'll be back, of course, she'll continue with the sessions, and because this is a crucial time, बहुत important time है. तो एटलीस्ट रोज एक लाइव सेशन करने की कोशिश करेंगे जिसमें कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स के कुछ क्वेश्चंस उठा के कवर करेंगे एंड देन वील कम बैक टू दीज सेम टॉपिक्स येट अगेन एक बार पूरी साइकिल कंप्लीट होने के बाद. हेलो पंकज. तो हमने डिसाइड किया था कि हॉर्टिकल्चर कवर करेंगे, एनिमल हस्बेंड्री, इरीगेशन, फिशरी, सॉइल, ये एटलीस्ट कवर करेंगे और इसके साथ साथ इंग्लिश डिस्क्रिप्टिव भी कवर करेंगे. सो आई विल बी कवरिंग दैट एज वेल. सो इंग्लिश प्रॉब्ली आई विल हैव अ सेशन टुमारो where I'll be discussing with you some important topics of SA, and over a period of time, over the next about 10-15 days, I will also start discussing full comprehensive tests of English as well as phase 2 with you guys. Okay, hello Kamlesh. Hi Manish. ठीक है, तो session start करने से पहले थोड़ा सा let's wait for some students to arrive. Let's see, because it's only 1702. So abhi abhi start kiya hai logon ne aana. Some more people will be joining us. So I'll be starting then. In the meantime, if you've not subscribed to the channel, please do that. If you've not pressed the bell icon, do that. If you've not liked the video till now, do that. It takes only a minute to like the video, to share it on your social media platform. It gives me a lot of boost. Because more and more people are able to join me and study or understand things for free on YouTube, and these sessions are certainly very helpful. And this I realize every time after the examination. This year also after phase one, a lot of students mailed me, messaged me, and told me, "Sir, we did not have the money to enroll in your course, but through these live sessions, we were helped out a lot, and these live sessions helped in increasing our marks by 5 to 10 points, or in some cases even more. And especially in phase two, it will help you guys a lot of you guys to understand agriculture, because agriculture bahut complex lagta hai if you've not started with it. And at the same time, English descriptive, jo ek aur black hole hai, bahut complex lagta hai. Students don't know how to attempt an essay, what to write, what not to write, वो सारी चीजें समझ नहीं आती. And for me to check thousands of papers is not possible, तो इसलिए YouTube is the best possible way जिससे मैं ज्यादा से ज्यादा students तक reach कर सकता हूँ. Okay. Hello Manish, hello Vaishali. Anshul is asking a question. Hello Shubham, hello Sabir. The question is, please clear one doubt, is phase 2 different for the IT? सबसे पहले तो जो syllabus है वो notification में mentioned है, तो एक बार देख लो उसको. Secondly, for all the different fields, the phase 2 is going to be different. Finance में हो तो उसका अलग होगा, IT में हो तो उसका अलग होगा, ठीक है ना. तो आपको वो देखना पड़ेगा एक बार कि सिलेबस एग्जैक्टली IT वालों का क्या है, अलग है तो क्या है, अलग नहीं है, मेंशन नहीं है कुछ भी, देन इट मीन्स इट्स गोइंग टू बी द सेम. अगर सेम है तो फिर आपको सेम ही चीज़ पढ़नी है. ओके, तो एक बार PDF देख लो. द PDF इज अवेलेबल ऑनलाइन एवरीवेयर. It's very easily available. So have a look at the PDF. It takes only 5 minutes. Okay, do that. Thanks, Vaishali. Vaishali says she subscribed. Sohas says, "Ji sir." Hello, Sohas. Okay, you're welcome, Anshul. Please look at it for 5 minutes. Ek baar dhoond lo. Even after that, if you're not clear, if you've glanced through the notification, if you're not clear, you can get back to me. I'll be there, I'll be available. Okay, Pankaj is asking, I'm already working with a bank and not able to find enough time to study. See, the best way to go forward if you do not have enough time is to take mocks. Okay, abhi mere mock start nahi hue, probably today evening I'll be sending out the first mock. So mocks are the best way. Ab usme khali aapko mock mein khali test leke chhodna nahi hai. You don't have to leave it immediately after taking the test. After you're done with the test, try and cover the entire topic. Google it. Google is the best medicine, I can say, for you guys. So let's say, agar koi example lete hain, pehle hi question lete hain. Let's say the question is, which of the following is a fruit thinning growth regulator? NAA, GA3, ethylene, IAA, none of the above. तो इसको एक बार देखोगे, फ्रूट थिनिंग ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर, तो आपको पता लगा अच्छा फ्रूट थिनिंग क्या होता है, ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर क्या होता है, इसको गूगल कर लिया, समझ लिया, देन गूगल ऑल दीज टर्म्स, ऑल दीज फोर टर्म्स, ठीक है, समझ आ जाएगा. इट टेक्स सम टाइम बट इट्स बेटर देन गोइंग थ्रू ऑल दोज ह्यूज पीडीएफ्स और वीडियोज दैट आई हैव प्रोवाइडेड एंड आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग. तो जिस तरह से मैं द वे आई एम अप्रोचिंग ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस इन दीज लाइव सेशंस, यू हैव टू फॉलो द सेम अप्रोच एंड दैट इज हाउ यू कैन एक्चुअली यू नो स्कोर वेरी वेल इन द एग्जाम. बिकॉज through these mocks, through questions, whatever they might be, either they are in live sessions or elsewhere, what you are doing is you are covering topics and not just covering those questions. So at the end of the day, at the end of 1 month, you will have covered enough topics. That will help you a lot. No, mocks are not free. They have not been released yet. Tonight, I will be releasing the first mock. So I said 10 mocks total I will release. Okay. They'll be very cheap, they won't be expensive at all, probably 700-800 bucks. So they're not even breaking point for us, break even point for us. But NMA mocks release karte hain to sabke liye kar dete hain. No, there is no course for UPSC EPFO exam because other than accounting, everything else, accounting and auditing, everything else is covered through UPSC only. So humko lagta hai ki hum zyada value addition nahi kar sakte. You cannot add a lot of value to your preparation, and that's why there's no course till now. Good evening, Vikas. Arijit is saying I'm getting around 117. Kya karun? Keep preparing. 117 is very close to the cutoff. If the marks reduce even by a little bit through normalization or through because of other factors, then you might get through. Preparing for a week is not hurtful. Is not going to hurt you at all. ठीक है ना? More knowledge is never a problem for anybody. Less knowledge is. तो prepare करते रहो. Let's keep preparing for the next 1 week, 2 weeks till the time the result is out. Then you think about what is to be done. Okay? Webhav, the problem with short notes. Now, what is short notes? If I tell you something very briefly. And if something comes in the exam which is in more detail, then you will feel that I covered it in brief and they took money also and they did not explain things in detail. So that's a problem. If I provide you everything in detail, then the problem is time is not enough. Okay, so you have to have that compromise. Of course, there is a course of ESI and I think there's a course of ARD which is available on my website. Some students asked for it. It's very cheap, I think 3000, 3500, something like that. So it covers the entire syllabus. I'm covering the current affairs and through these sessions I'm trying to cover even more. They'll have mocks also. So I'm already covering those things, but you won't find any source which covers everything very briefly. There is a website I think LST, which covers some things related to ARD, but they're very brief. The problem is that they're very brief. I've referred to the entire website. It looks very attractive, but at the same time, they're very brief. So the basics will get cleared. You will, of course, have some advantage, but at the same time, it won't be comprehensive enough or enough. Okay. No idea of ST cutoff. Not daily series. Rishabh is asking daily series, not daily, but I'll make sure that whenever I'm covering something, I'm covering it in detail. ठीक है ना? वो daily वाला चक्कर नहीं है यहाँ पे. Okay, let us start with the session. We have some students here. Start kar dete hain session ko. Yes, whatever you are preparing in ESI for RBI NABARD exam, it's going to be very useful for RBI. NABARD ka jo ESI syllabus hai, that is bigger than RBI syllabus. So it's going to be useful. Theek hai. First question se start karte hain. You have 1 minute to answer the question. The question is, which of the following is a fruit thinning? These are the terms: fruit thinning, growth regulator, NAA, GA3, ethylene, IAA, none of the above. Let's have the answers, guys. 1 minute hai aapke paas, nahi aata hai to skip likho, aata hai to answer karo, and then I will pick up all these one by one. Ethylene, GA3, fruit thinning, growth regulator ki baat ho rahi hai, growth inhibitor या फिर ग्रोथ डेवलपर या इंक्रीज करने की बात नहीं हो रही है, रेगुलेटर की बात हो रही है एंड फ्रूट थिनिंग, दैट इज अनदर थिंग. अब फ्रूट थिनिंग का मतलब भी समझेंगे एक बार, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डज इट मीन. IAA, NAA, एथिलीन, स्किप, लॉट ऑफ कंफ्यूजन, एवरीबडी इज गिविंग अ डिफरेंट आंसर. लॉट ऑफ एथिलीन्स, लॉट ऑफ IAA, लॉट ऑफ NAA. ओके, टाइम इज अप गाइस, लेट्स ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डू दीज टर्म्स मीन and how exactly to crack this question. Abhi pura hum samajh lenge ek bar, of course it's going to take some time, but pay utmost attention to this. Now fruit thinning kab hota hai, when does fruit thinning take place? Let's say there is a mango tree, and in that mango tree, or there's a full plantation, and in that plantation there are, let's say, 100 mango trees, aur usme har mango tree mein on an average, let's say, hone chahiye 40 mangoes. theek hai na. So this is the average that should be, average that should be, but the actual average, let's say last year, the actual average which was seen was, let's say, 70 mangoes. Okay, so the actual average was almost double of the average that should have been. Now what that results in, is okay, can you guys hear me again? I think there was some technical error. I kept teaching and I did not see these messages. Okay, we'll be starting again. Yeah, now it's fine. It was connected through LAN. I think there was some problem. Now I've connected it through the Wi-Fi. Okay, perfect. Okay, so let us start again. Okay, I'll bring in the question again and then we'll start. Okay, people will join us again, no problem. Okay, so the question was, which of the following is a fruit thinning growth regulator? So these are the keywords that we have: fruit thinning and growth regulator. You've already answered, majority of the students have already answered, so I'll just explain what exactly the question and the answer is and why is it so. So fruit thinning is one thing that you need to understand, and growth regulator, which can be either growth promoter or it can be growth inhibitor. We will talk about that as well. Okay. Now let me first explain to you what is fruit thinning and then we'll go forward. Okay. So let's say this is a mango tree, and let's say there's a plantation in which there are 100 such mango trees. Now, let's say the average, so another variable that we've taken is, another assumption is, let's say the average that should be, the average number of mangoes that should be grown on each tree in this plantation is, let's say, 40. But in reality, so actual average comes out to be, let's say, in this year, the actual average comes out to be 80. So the actual average is double of the average that should be in order to maintain the quality and the size, of mangoes on a tree. Okay, now what happens when the average number increases by such a great amount, such a great volume, it almost doubles, then you see that the quality and the size reduces of each mango, and thus it is not competitive in the market. So fruit thinning is done in order to reduce the volume or the amount of mangoes or any other fruit that is grown in the plantation, in order to ensure that there's an oversupply, and at the same time the oversupply does not result in more less quality and less size. Okay, so that is the actual meaning of fruit thinning. Now we have to understand which of the following chemicals or which of the following hormones result or are used for fruit thinning. And at the same time, what do you mean by growth regulators? What are growth inhibitors and what are growth promoters? Okay, so now let's try and understand them one by one. So here you can see plant growth regulators are called as PGRs. That's very normal. They can be either natural in nature, which means naturally occurring in nature, in which case they are called as phytohormones, or they can be synthetic in nature as well. That means they are created artificially through some chemicals. Okay. Now, whether they are naturally occurring or whether they are synthetic, they can be either growth promoters, which are used to promote growth. You see all the time all these big watermelons, big mangoes, big guavas coming in the market. They're all using these plant growth hormones. They might be using the naturally occurring ones or the synthetic ones that we don't know. Or they can be growth inhibitors. One example of which is NAA, which is used as fruit thinning growth regulator. Okay. So the answer to the question is NAA, in case you did not figure that out. Now, plant growth promoters, which are naturally occurring, are majorly of these three types: auxin, gibberellin, or cytokinin. And growth inhibitors are these two: ethylene and abscisic acid. That's why a lot of you gave the answer as ethylene, because you thought that fruit thinning growth regulator, we want to reduce the production, so ethylene should be the answer. But they are growth inhibitors and not fruit thinning chemicals. Fruit thinning is done specifically through NAA. Okay. Other answers are other synthetic growth regulators are 2,4-D, 2,4,5-T. Okay. Now let's understand growth promoters and inhibitors in a little more detail so that you understand on a broad level the definitions of these. So growth promoters, the main purpose of growth promoters is to promote the following: cell division, cell enlargement, flowering, fruiting, and seed formation. So these are the major purposes of growth promoters. Basically, when you increase cell division, when you increase cell enlargement, when you increase flowering and fruiting, then naturally at the same time you're increasing the growth capability of a particular plant. That's why they are growth promoters. And then the opposite is done through growth inhibitors, which are chemicals which reduce or stop growth of a plant or a fruit. The purpose is to increase dormancy and abscission in plants, which also is important in some cases, and I'll be talking about that as well through questions in the future. Okay, so we'll be talking about that as well. Now, I hope you have understood what exactly is NAA, what is fruit thinning, what are growth regulators, growth promoters, growth inhibitors, what are the major examples. Let's go through five major categories of growth regulators which are synthetic in nature. Write them down if you don't know it already. The PDF is already being shared with all the enrolled students, so they don't need to write it down. The five major categories of synthetic compounds which are growth regulators might be growth inhibitor, might be growth promoter. They are indole acids, IAs, naphthalene acid, NAs, chlorophenoxy acid, benzoic acid, and picolinic acid derivatives. These are major synthetic ones which are growth regulators. At the same time, besides IAA, plants contain three other compounds which are structurally similar and elicit many of the same response as that of IAA, which are basically acids which are used for growth regulation. They are chloroindole acetic acid, CIAA, PAA, phenyl acetic acid, and indole butyric acid, which is IBA. So IBA is very important. That can also be asked in the examination. Okay. So these are the major growth regulators other than NAA and the ones that I've explained to you. Any doubts in this question, or we will move forward? Okay, nothing. So let's move forward. The next question that we have, and I give you 1 minute for this. The question is, which of the following is known as the queen of spices? Not the king of spices, we're talking about the queen of spices. You also have to tell me simultaneously what is king of spices. Okay, that's another thing that I want from you guys. King of spices, queen of spices, why are they called so? What are the reasons? Black peppers. Nilesh says black pepper. Black pepper, you're saying black pepper is the answer for this? Okay, Nilesh says black pepper is queen of spices. Ritika says one, cardamom is queen of spices. Answer is NAA of the previous question. D. Vaishali says D,
coriander. Another one says A.
Cardamom. Cardamom. Manish says cardamom. Sorry, don't Google,
please.
Okay, cardamom. Yes, the answer is in fact cardamom.
Cardamom is the queen of spices, and black pepper is the king of spices.
Now let's understand briefly about cardamom.
Before we move to that, let me tell you some important things about cardamom.
Okay,
first of all, India is the second largest producer of cardamom in the world. Second largest producer of cardamom in the world.
And you would not believe it, the US and the UK are the major consumers of cardamom even now, but they don't produce it a lot. And the reason that they started trade with India at the first place was that they discovered cardamom as a spice here. They really liked it. They started importing it a lot. And now they're the ones who consume majority of it. Indians, on the other hand, are the major producers of cardamom in the world.
Kerala in India, out of the entire production, Kerala produces 70% of cardamom. And in Kerala, Idukki district, a question can be asked from this. Idukki district is the district which is responsible or popular for majority of cardamom produce. After Kerala, we have Karnataka with 20%. And after that, we have Tamil Nadu with the remaining 10%. So all the southern states of India are responsible. In fact, major spices are produced or available in the southern states of India only. So this is about black cardamom. Black pepper is the king of spices. Now this is the scientific name, Eleutheria cardamom, cardamomum. That is the scientific name, and this is the family. Zingiberaceae is the family of cardamom. Okay. This is the world's third most expensive spice after vanilla and saffron. So this is another question that can be asked, which is the world's most expensive spice, second most expensive spice, and the third most expensive spice. It is naturally grown in areas with an elevation of 600 to 1500 meters above sea level. Okay, so remember that as well. Very well can be asked in the examination, because it's a plantation crop, that's why it comes under horticulture, if you don't know that already. Thick shady areas with forest loamy soil are ideal for cultivating cardamom. pH range, remember the pH range, very important, 5 to 6.5, that is number one. And second is, they're grown in forests. If you have ever seen or witnessed or even seen in pictures how wine is grown, how grapes are grown, it's very similar. The only difference is that it needs more shade, that's why it's grown in forests. Okay. The normal growing season is June to December, although cardamom is a perennial crop, that means it's grown down the year, but June to December is the normal season when it is sown and harvested. Okay. Seedlings or suckers can be used for propagation. Propagation means expansion or multiplication. Seedlings can be used. So what happens in cardamom is, let's say you have a seed. So you grow a seed in a nursery for a while, and when it becomes a seedling, that means it has leaves or something else, when it starts growing, then you take it out and you move it to the forest where you actually plant it. So seedlings or suckers, which are the same, can be used for propagation. Okay. Larger types, 2.5 to 2 meters, smaller types, 2 to 1.5 meters. This is the difference between all the seeds, all the plants. So this is the amount of distance that they need in order to grow properly. Okay. It's grown as a rain-fed crop, which means you do not need much irrigation for growing cardamom. Okay. I hope that's clear. Rain-fed, fed by rain. Pests. So these are the major pests which affect the growth of cardamom. Remember these, you have to of course mug up a lot of pests: thrips, shoot, panicle, capsule borer, and root grubs. These are the pests which affect the growth of cardamom. And diseases which affect the growth of cardamom: leaf spot, leaf rot, collar rot. This is in nursery. Clump rot and katte. Katte is a virus transmitted by banana aphid. So banana aphid is another pest which affects banana, and at the same time can also affect the growth of cardamom by affecting it with a disease called as cardia. Okay, so remember that as well. Marijuana of Iduki might be popular, but they will never ask that question in the exam. Okay. Next question, guys. Let us start with the timer. The question is, Ciga toka leaf spot is a serious disease in which of the following? Banana, coconut, grapes, guava, or lychee. Ciga toka leaf spot is a serious disease in which of the following? Let's see who answers it correctly. Not a very difficult question. Ciga toka leaf spot. Somebody says coconut. B. Somebody says D. D is guava. Ciga toka leaf spot is a serious disease in which of the following? Only 20 seconds left. B, A, lychee. Lychee is E. We have somebody saying A as well. Time is up, guys. Okay, I see a lot of confusion here. The answer to this question is A, banana, which only I think one person answered correctly. The answer is A, banana. Ciga toka leaf spot. It's a fungal disease. It's a fungal disease which affects the growth of banana. Let's understand how it exactly looks. Okay, now they can be yellow spots and they can be black spots. So these are two different kinds. So you can have yellow streaks or spots, or you can have black spots as well, or black streaks as well. So these are two different diseases of the Ciga toka family only. Okay, this is the scientific name, Pseudocercospora musicola. Very difficult to remember, of course, but you can try and do it. It was first discovered in Ciga toka Valley in Fiji. So this is something that can also be asked in the examination, and that's why it's called as Ciga toka disease. Symptom. The first visible symptom is a slight discoloration between the leaf's secondary veins. So as you can see here, this is the leaf, but you see there is slight discoloration here between the leaf's veins. These are the veins, and you see some discoloration here. So that is the first. Now it's very difficult, because when I first read about it, I thought that this is very similar to how naturally a seed, a leaf progresses and dies. This looks much more like a natural progression or life cycle of a leaf. But this is where you can actually differentiate between a natural life cycle. So C and D are the points where you can differentiate, and that is through yellow streaks. So if there are yellow streaks, then you know that it's something related to a disease. Okay. The repressed gray center is surrounded by a yellow halo or a spot. As the disease progresses, the lesion swells and cover a large area of the leaf. Dendron and Robusta are highly susceptible. Not very important for us. Okay. So this is about Ciga toka. I hope you understood it. Ciga toka leaf spot is seen in banana. It can be yellow streaks or it can be black as well. Okay. Next question. That's enough. That was there in the previous one. Fasciation is a rare condition of abnormal growth in vascular tissue, and therefore the fruit becomes completely useless. This condition is found in which of the following? So we are talking about fasciation, rare condition of abnormal growth in vascular tissue. Abnormal growth in vascular tissue. This is going to be very interesting. I've actually seen it, and it was amazing to see something like that. A is apple. Somebody says pineapple. Mayan says pineapple, which is option C. Okay, let's have more answers. Nishant says B, lychee. Nilesh says sapota. E. Manish says apple. Another one here saying apple. Manish Himalaya said lychee also, and he said apple also. So let me remove lychee. D3, D and 3. Okay, so we have 2 for pineapple, 2 for apple, 1 for lychee and 1 for sapota. Okay, Ritika says C, pineapple. The answer to this question is in fact C, pineapple. What exactly happens in fasciation is that there is abnormal growth in vascular tissue. Very similar to what happens in cancer if you want to generalize it, although it's not the same, but there is abnormal growth of cells. Okay, so there's rapid cell growth which results in something like bursting. The fruit loses its shape, becomes something completely different, and that happens because of fasciation, which is basically rapid cell growth. So if you think about cancer, you can actually understand it. Okay, there's another thing which results in fasciation. There's one major thing which results in fasciation in plants and fruits, and that is ratooning. So what happens in ratooning, which we have often heard because of all the pollution, higher pollution levels in Delhi, is that let's say this is a sugarcane. This is one particular stem of sugarcane which is used when it's harvested. Now what happens is normally farmers, instead of taking out the entire thing along with the roots, do not take out the entire thing and cut it off from above the root, and therefore what is left is the root hair and a part of the stem. And they use the same root and the same stem to grow it again. Now what happens when you do that is that this often results in something called as fasciation, which means abnormal growth. Because you're using the same root, the same stem, plants have a tendency, a lot of plants have a tendency of experiencing fasciation or abnormal growth in their cells, and that results in the plant or the fruit looking something completely different. Okay, so they're, to simplify, deformed to such an extent they're totally useless, they cannot be consumed anymore because they're deformed, their cell structure is such that they cannot be consumed at all. Okay, so in case of pineapple, when it happens, it is highly flattened and twisted with innumerable crowns. So you can see here, the timer is gone, let me show it to you. So this is a normal, this is how a normal pineapple would look like, and this is how, you know, a fasciated pineapple looks like. It is flat, you cannot consume it at all, it is not round like this, and it is non-consumable. Okay, so this is an example of how fasciation works. High fertility of soil. So in case you're putting in more fertilizers than you should be, that also results in fasciation. Warm weather and calcium or zinc deficiency may favor fasciation. Control, avoid ratooning. This is where it is mentioned that I wanted to explain beforehand only. So remember these things: high fertility of soil, deficiency of calcium or zinc, and warm weather can result in fasciation. Okay, I think that's clear. Let's move on to the next question. Which of the following is highly salt tolerant fruit tree? A very commonsensical question. Let's see who answers it correctly. Vaishali says, please Hindi. Chalo, let's start with Hindi and see. Kisi ko Hindi samajh mein nahi aati hai, Let's see, I'll try that, okay? I think my English is very clear. I don't understand why you could not understand. Okay, let's see the answers. Mayan says date palm, that is option C. Saurabh says E, that is falsa. Ritika says C, date palm. Then C. A lot of C's coming here. Date, Saurabh now says date. Okay, so he wants to change it. Probably following what others are doing. I don't know what exactly happened there. Yes, the answer is date palm. Okay, so it's a salt tolerant crop. Even if you don't know, I think you can understand by connecting salt with the temperature. So if you go to West Asia where there are deserts all around, yes,
the salt levels are very high, and in that kind of weather also you see a lot of date palm trees, which is exported from those countries to India as well. I'm very sure you've eaten date palm, which is packed and exported to India. So that is because date palm has the ability to grow even in high salt areas. Okay, I hope you understand the Hindi. I am a little slow now. You understand the English, I'll try and use some Hindi as well. Okay, so highly salt tolerant fruity, date palm is the answer. Some more similarly, or kuch jo hain, which are also highly salt tolerant, are barley, pearl millet, theek hai? And then you have vegetables which are salt tolerant. Keep writing them down if you are not, because ho sakta hai wo slide mein mention na ho. Vegetables mein you have beetroot, agave. I have written them down, agave, and they are taken from the notes. Ye notes se nikale hue hain choti choti cheeze. And fruit tree mein ber, ber yahan par mention hai, fruit tree mein ber is another example along with date palm. Isko hum zizifers bhi bolte hain, zizifers bhi bolte hain. Okay, so ye likh sakte ho, please write them down. ठीक है, तो अब समझते हैं थोड़ा सा और सॉल्ट्स के बारे में, जो सॉल्ट टॉलरेंट ट्रीज हैं या फिर प्लांट्स हैं. कोकोनट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सॉल्ट टॉलरेंट फ्रूट ट्रीज दैट यू कैन ग्रो इन द गार्डन. टेक्निकली द कोकोनट इज अ ड्रूप व्हिच इज अ फ्रूट विद अ हार्ड आउटर कवरिंग ओवर द सीड. ड्रूप ये याद रखिएगा, एंड कोकोनट इज सॉल्ट टॉलरेंट, रिमेंबर दिस एज वेल. Date palm is a drought-resistant desert palm native to North America. The date palm is used for both its fruits and as a landscape plant. दोनों तरीके से use होता है. Fig. Fig is another one, native of the Mediterranean, basically जो भी area Europe के नीचे है. Figs tolerate drought, saline soils and salt spray and can be grown in coastal regions. तो fig याद रखिएगा. Pomegranate, tolerant to saline conditions. That's another fruit. Key lime, also known as Mexican lime and West Indies lime, native to Southeast Asia, moderately tolerant. So key lime yaad rakhiyega. Ye sare salt tolerant fruits, vegetables, plantation crops ke examples hain. Pomelo, it tolerates brackish water such as reclaimed water and poor drainage. So pomelo brackish water tolerate karta hai, to agar pani kharab hai kahin pe aapko kuch grow karna hai, pomelo will grow there. Okay, तो ये सारे हो गए हमारे एग्जांपल्स. ऑल दीज आर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ सॉल्ट टॉलरेंट वंस. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, ये भी बहुत कॉमन सेंस वाला नहीं है, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस. ओके, द क्वेश्चन इज फ्रूट्स बेस्ड ऑन रेस्पिरेशन कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज. रेस्पिरेशन के बेसिस पे जो फ्रूट्स हम क्लासिफिकेशन करते हैं, तो फ्रूट, आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज रेस्पिरेशन. रेस्पिरेशन फ्रूट्स में भी होता है, इवन आफ्टर दे प्लक्ड उसके बाद भी होता है. तो रेस्पिरेशन जो होता है, दैट कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज वन ऑफ द फाइव अबव. मयंक सेज क्लाइमेटेरिक, क्लाइमेटेरिक, नॉन क्लाइमेटेरिक. वैशाली, आई गेट योर पॉइंट. वॉट एवर क्वेश्चन यू हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड, जो भी कॉन्सेप्ट समझ नहीं आया एक बार बता दो, आई विल मूव बैक आफ्टर दिस क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, बी, टू मोर बीज, वन मोर बी, क्लाइमेक्टेरिक, नॉन क्लाइमेक्टेरिक. यस, मयंक इज राइट. मयंक हैज रेड थिंग्स प्रॉपरली. नाइस वन मयंक, कंग्रेचुलेशंस. आई थिंक यू रेड ऑल दीज ब्यूटिफुली. यू रिमेंबर मेजोरिटी ऑफ दीज थिंग्स एंड यू आर आंसरिंग योर द क्वेश्चंस ऑल्सो वेरी वेल. ठीक है, नाइस वन. वैशाली ऑल्सो सेज बी. द आंसर इज इन फैक्ट बी, क्लाइमेक्टेरिक, नॉन क्लाइमेक्टेरिक. एक बार समझ लेते हैं एग्जैक्टली है क्या क्लाइमेटेरिक, नॉन क्लाइमेटेरिक. तो फ्रूट्स आर क्लासिफाइड एज क्लाइमेटेरिक एंड नॉन क्लाइमेटेरिक बेस्ड ऑन देयर रेस्पिरेशन एंड एथिलीन प्रोडक्शन रेट्स ड्यूरिंग डेवलपमेंट, मैच्योरिटी, राइपनिंग एंड सेनेसेंस. तो फ्रूट जब ग्रो होना शुरू होता है तब वो रेस्पिरेट करता है. रेस्पिरेशन बेसिकली मीन्स एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस. CO2 ले रहा है, ऑक्सीजन ले रहा है, CO2 निकाल रहा है, ऑल दिस इज रेस्पिरेशन. ठीक है,
बेस्ड ऑन देयर रेस्पिरेशन उनको दो टाइप्स में किया जाता है, क्लाइमेक्टेरिक एंड नॉन क्लाइमेक्टेरिक, ठीक है। एंड एथिलीन प्रोडक्शन, एथिलीन ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस होगा तो एक चीज होगी, एथिलीन प्रोड्यूस नहीं होगा तो कुछ और होगा, विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट। आई होप रेस्पिरेशन का मतलब समझ आ गया। क्लाइमेक्टेरिक फ्रूट्स आर दोस फ्रूट्स व्हिच आर एसोसिएटेड विद इंक्रीज्ड एथिलीन प्रोडक्शन एंड हाई सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन ड्यूरिंग राइपनिंग। अब एथिलीन प्रोडक्शन होगा तो राइपनिंग जल्दी होगी क्योंकि रेस्पिरेशन जल्दी होगा। एंड क्लाइमेक्टेरिक फ्रूट्स आर दोस फ्रूट्स जिनका रेस्पिरेशन का लेवल ज्यादा होता है, रेस्पिरेशन की इंटेंसिटी ज्यादा होती है, एथिलीन प्रोडक्शन की इंटेंसिटी ज्यादा होती है, जिसकी वजह से जल्दी राइपनिंग होती है। रिमेंबर दैट आफ्टर इवन आफ्टर प्लकिंग ऑफ द फ्रूट, जैसे बनाना, इवन आफ्टर प्लकिंग ऑफ द फ्रूट बिकॉज देर इज हाइटेंड एथिलीन प्रोडक्शन, दैट्स व्हाई देर इज हाइटेंड सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन एंड हाइटेंड और इंक्रीज राइपनिंग, ठीक है ना। So that is a climacteric fruit. Non-climacteric is opposite, जिसमें ethylene production कम होता है, ripening is slow and it can even go into dormancy after its plucking. For example, you have cashew nuts here. The most common example. Cashew अगर लेंगे तो because it can last longer because the respiration level is almost nil. Non-climacteric fruits once harvested do not ripen further. Non-climacteric fruits produce very small amount of ethylene and do not respond to ethylene treatment. So ethylene production भी नहीं हो रहा है और ethylene treatment को respond भी नहीं करेंगे even if you want to inject ethylene artificially and let them ripen. Examples, please remember the examples, very important. Apple, apricot, avocado, banana, biriba, blueberry, breadfruit, fig, guava, jackfruit, kiwi fruit, mango, marshmallow, nectarine, papaya, passion fruit, peach, pear, plantain, plum, saputa, tomato, watermelon. Major जितने भी fruits हम लोग normally खाते हैं, all those are ripening and climacteric. And non-climacteric are blackberry, cacao, cashew, apple. Apple ये दोनों में डाला हुआ है because climacteric है but at the same time respiration level is very slow. तो climacteric है, ethylene production है but it is very very slow. That's why दोनों में डाला हुआ है, इट रिप्रेजेंट्स दी फीचर्स ऑफ बोथ ऑफ दीज, ओके। क्यूकंबर, चेरी, एगप्लांट, ग्रेप, ग्रेपफ्रूट, जिजुबे, लेमन, लाइम, ऑलिव, ऑरेंज, पेपर, पाइनएप्पल, पोमेग्रेनेट, रास्पबेरी, स्ट्रॉबेरी, समर स्क्वॉश, टैंजरी, ये सारे नॉन क्लाइमेटिक, ठीक है। चलो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, लेट्स कम टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन। द क्वेश्चन इज ओके, बिफोर मूविंग ऑन, okay, might be cashew, apple, let's see. Vaishali had said ki ek question unko samajh nahi aaya tha. Vaishali, please tell me which question you were not clear with. Ek baar phir se utha lete hain before moving forward. So with hamare 6 questions ho gaye hain, we are now with 7th question. First question, ठीक है। First question, fruit stemming growth regulator. तो एक बार first question, let's cover it again for the because Vaishali is requesting it, ठीक है। तो growth regulator, अब आपको plants हैं और उसमें fruits हैं, you want to regulate their growth. या तो उसकी ग्रोथ बढ़ानी है, यू वांट टू इधर प्रमोट द ग्रोथ और यू वांट टू इनहिबिट द ग्रोथ फॉर वेरियस रीजंस। जैसे आपको वाटरमेलन आजकल मिलता है, इट्स ह्यूज, यू सी गुआवास, दे आर ह्यूज, दे आर ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ दीज ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर्स, उनकी ग्रोथ प्रमोट करके उनको बढ़ावा ना देते हैं एंड देन दे सेल इट टू यू, ओके, बिकॉज दे लुक ब्यूटीफुल। सो इधर यू कैन रेगुलेट द ग्रोथ बाय इंक्रीजिंग द ग्रोथ, प्रमोटिंग द ग्रोथ और बाय इनहिबिटिंग द ग्रोथ। फ्रूट थिनिंग इज अ फिनोमेना जो मैंने एक्सप्लेन किया था। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एक मैंगो ट्री है, उस पर कुछ फ्रूट्स हैं एंड द नेचुरल नंबर ऑफ फ्रूट्स, नेचुरल नंबर ऑफ मैंगोज दैट कैन ग्रो ऑन दिस ट्री इज लेट्स से 40 इन अ ईयर। और अभी एक्चुअल में क्या हो गया है, लेट्स से बिकॉज ऑफ सम रीजन, किसी वजह से उसके अंदर कुछ बायोलॉजिकल चेंजेस आ रहे हैं, अभी वो इट हैज इंक्रीज टू 80। सो व्हेन द प्रोडक्शन सडनली गोज अप नेचुरली, देन द क्वालिटी एंड द साइज ऑफ फ्रूट इज अफेक्टेड। साइज छोटा हो जाएगा बिकॉज देयर इज लिमिटेड न्यूट्रिशन दैट द tree has, therefore the size of the fruit will compress and the quality of fruit is also affected.
तो इट विल नॉट बी सेलेबल इन द मार्केट एनी मोर. तो फार्मर्स क्या करते हैं, हॉर्टिकल्चरिस्ट क्या करते हैं, दे ट्राई एंड इनहिबिट द ग्रोथ. उसका उसको बोलते हैं फ्रूट थिनिंग, जिससे कि वो 80 से कम होकर 40 पे आ जाए फिर से, या 40-50 पे रुक जाए. सो NAA इज द केमिकल, इज द सिंथेटिक केमिकल दैट इज यूज फॉर फ्रूट थिनिंग. ओके, सो द आंसर वॉज NAA. अब जो ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर्स हैं, दे कैन बी प्रोमोटर्स, इनहिबिटर्स, जो मैंने बताया. प्रोमोटर्स आर ऑक्सिन, जिबरेलिन एंड साइटोकिनिन नॉर्मली, एंड इनहिबिटर्स में एथिलीन एंड एब्सिसिक एसिड. दीज आर टू इनहिबिटर्स जो नॉर्मली नेचुरली एग्री होते हैं. दे कैन बी सिंथेटिक इनहिबिटर्स और प्रोमोटर्स एज वेल. NAA 240 एंड 245T, दीज आर मेजर ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर्स विच आर सिंथेटिक इन नेचर, जो केमिकल से बनते हैं, विच आर नॉट नेचुरल. ओके, सो दिस इज वॉट ऑल आई एक्सप्लेन. ग्रोथ प्रोमोटर में आप ग्रोथ बढ़ाने की कोशिश करोगे थ्रू सेल डिविजन, सेल एनलार्जमेंट, फ्लावरिंग, फ्रूटिंग एंड सीड फॉर्मेशन. और ग्रोथ इनहिबिटर में आप डोमेंसी क्रिएट करने की कोशिश करोगे सो दैट दे डोंट ग्रो एनी मोर, जिससे कि आप ग्रोथ को कम कर सको. ओके, आई होप दैट्स क्लियर नाउ. ठीक है, लेट्स कम टू द सेवंथ क्वेश्चन. ये हो गया था, लेट्स कम टू दिस. Drowsiness and whip tail are physiological disorder of dash. You have 1 minute to answer the question. Drowsiness, whip tail, physiological disorders of dash. Mayam says cauliflower, nice one. Answered it immediately. Molybdenum deficiency, whip tail of cauliflower, nice one. Nice one, Mayan. He seems to be very well read on these things. Nice one. 245T, 24D can be used as weedicide if used in higher concentrations. Anamika Patnaik says C, cauliflower. Okay, time is up. Yes, the answer is in fact C, cauliflower. Whip tail. This here you can see whip tail. How exactly it looks. This is a normal and this is how it looks after the leaf formation. In this condition, the leaf blades do not develop properly and become trap-like. The growing point severely deformed. No marketable color is formed. Cause deficiency of molybdenum. Acidic soils below 4-5 pH level. So, acidic soil ki wajah se ya phir molybdenum ki deficiency ki wajah se jo Mayan ne bataya, whip tail can occur. And the next one was riciness. A premature initiation of floral buds, ये दूसरा है जिसमें जो फ्लोरल बर्ड्स होते हैं जो हम नॉर्मली खाते हैं कॉलीफ्लावर के, वो ज़्यादा जल्दी ग्रो हो जाते हैं. दैट्स वाई दे बिकम राइसी लाइक, दे लुक लाइक राइस. इन दिस केस द पेडंकल इलोंगेट्स एंड द कर्ड बिकम्स ग्रैनुलर एंड लूज. तो वो लूज हो जाता है बहुत ज़्यादा, दिस ग्रैनुलर एट द टॉप एंड पेडंकल इज बेसिकली द शूट, वो ज़्यादा लंबा हो जाता है. ओके, द कॉजेज यू नीड टू रिमेंबर, कॉज दोनों के याद रखना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. Heavy nitrogen, high RH and rampant growth. So these are the major reasons for these two deficiencies in cauliflower. ठीक है, next question पे आते हैं. Which of the following is a vector for transmitting leaf curl virus in vegetable crops? Leaf curl virus vector, which one is used? Which of the following is a vector which transmits this virus in vegetable crops? Let's have the answer, guys. Somebody says thrips, somebody says B, chrysoperla, Mayan says thrips. Thrips is also a vector, but vegetable crops mein leaf curl virus ke case mein vector nahi hai. Raj has announced this already in the announcement section on Telegram. This is available in ARD agriculture ka jo folder hai uske andar ye dal diye maine already. Theek hai, you can find the video also there. Iske baad usko wahan pe embed kar denge. Okay, so the answer to this question is white fly. Mayank was partially right because potentially right, because thrips and aphids,
aphids and thrips
are also used as vectors for, but for different viral diseases. Okay, now there's one more thing that I had written,
Chrysoperla. Yes, Chrysoperla is not used as a vector but as a predator. So what it does is Chrysoperla eats or feeds on these vectors.
So Chrysoperla is grown basically to control the growth of these vectors, which
actually
spread these viral diseases. Okay, so it feeds on these different vectors. Okay, similarly honeybee
is again not a vector. Okay, so this is about aphids, thrips, honeybees. Ek bar let's have a look at leaf curl. So we're talking about leaf curl virus, so let's talk about leaf curl here. Leaf curl mein kya kya hota hai? Leaves curl towards midrib and become deformed. So leaves is tarah se jo curl dikh raha hai yahan par, this you can see there. So this is a normal leaf and this is how a leaf curl looks like. Stunted plant growth due to shortened internodes and leaves greatly reduced in size. Flower buds abscise before attaining full size and anthers do not contain pollen grains basically, and pollen ki growth khatam ho gayi, flower bud bhi khatam ho gaye. So it inhibits their ability to grow further, to multiply. The virus is generally transmitted by white fly, so control measures of white fly in this regard would be helpful for whatever that is. Okay, that's not important really for this question. So you might have seen this a lot on the side of the road when you're traveling, or even outside your house. If you go look at any plant on the side of the road, you would see that majority of them are affected by this. So it's a very profoundly available and can be seen very easily, okay, everywhere. The crop grown for grain, green manure and fodder, very important question. What is the other question? Which of the following is a crop grown for? Number one, grain ke liye bhi use hota hai, manure ke liye bhi use hota hai, and as a fodder bhi use hota hai. Which of the following is the answer? cowpea, lobia, Satyam says chickpea. So we have a lot of cowpea, lobia,
some chickpeas.
D, again one more D, cowpea.
Chickpea,
some chickpeas,
some more cowpeas.
Okay, I think very close. A lot of students said chickpeas, a lot of students said cowpeas. The answer is cowpea.
Or kya kya example ho sakte hain? Crops grown for grain, green manure and fodder. So we have green gram and we have pigeon pea.
And we have pigeon pea as well. Okay, so these are also used for grains, green manure and fodder. Tino cheezo ke liye use hote hain. Okay, legumes like cowpea, horse gram, green gram improves precipitation use efficiency during off season, also known as lobia. Ye to aapko samajh pata hi tha. Puts in nitrogen, karta kya hai? Nitrogen builds organic matter, smothers weeds and controls nematodes. Pigeon pea, टोड या अरड़ जो बोलते हैं, is also extensively used as green manure. ठीक है, very simple, very factual question. Let's come to the next one. Fruit exhibit in a cold chamber storage, not exhibit. Fruits in a cold chamber storage exhibits longer storage life because of cash. Let's have the answer, guys. The rate of respiration is decreased, says Mayan. K Singh says A, the rate of respiration is decreased. This is the last question, by the way. B, somebody says B, there is an increase in humidity. It's a very, this one, this is a commonsensical question. Isme aapko koi knowledge ki zarurat nahi hai.
even if you go through all the options, you will be able to answer this. Yes.
The answer is, in fact, A. The rate of respiration is decreased when you put it in a cold chamber, and that is how you increase the storage life. Okay? It's very common sense, you will know rocket science here. Ek cheez isme dhyan rakh sakte hain, yahan pe mentioned hai ya nahi, it's not mentioned here, let me tell you. Respiration is halved for every drop in temperature by 10 degrees centigrade, 10 degrees Celsius. So, respiration becomes half for every drop in temperature by 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, remember this, fruits and vegetables continue their metabolic activity after harvest. Also, metabolic activity is manifested by respiration. Respiration, maine aapko already samjha diya hai. Reduction of temperature is an effective means of reducing rate of respiration. Temperature kam karoge, isliye fridge mein rakhte hain to jaldi kharab nahi hoti cheeze. Cooler temperature means slow respiration, means longer shelf life. Isliye cold storages itne zyada importance mein hain aajkal. Okay, because we want to reduce the increase the life cycle, we want to reduce their respiration, and we want to have them ready to eat for a longer time period. I hope that's clear. Very well done. Majority of these, I think Mayan was the major one who was answering things, answering questions beautifully. So very well done. I want to see more of you guys being able to answer more questions regularly in the future as well. Kal mostly hum log English ka ek, we'll have one session of English tomorrow, and the day after tomorrow we'll have session of irrigation, animal husbandry or fisheries. In maise koi ek session day after tomorrow we'll have that. Okay, tomorrow we'll have something on English descriptive, because I think that's very important. Woh tak start nahi kiya. Okay, all the very best guys, take care, have a nice day, keep studying. We have only a month, approximately a month to go, and let's use it to the max possibilities available. Let's focus as much as possible. Okay guys, take care, have a nice day.